They're claiming they know how to make the perfect Italian sauce.
That's already a bold statement.
If I was in Italy watching us, just chop
what
it up. It's just really not going to matter. I'm going to cook
if he was
these
in Italy,
onions
what?
For at least 10 yeah, minutes.
Yeah, they told him, don't go there.
They're going to melt.
The pasta that he picked up, it is not the perfect pasta. So if you want to make a perfect tomato sauce, choose slow-dried, bronze-extruded pasta shapes.
Four cloves of garlic in here as well.
Four cloves.
Okay, so he's mixing two different techniques here. He's mixing
smacking them with
a northerner Italian type of cooking, which uses a lot of onions, butter, and also the garlic and olive oil, which are more southerner. So he's mixing both. It's not taking the garlic sprouts inside.
That would be
usually the garlic green sprout inside the garlic clove is usually the bitter, less digestible part of the garlic.
We call it the soul. The soul.
The soul of the garlic. Yeah.
Extra virgin olive oil, so we're off to a good start. At least.
Looks nice and green.
Yeah. 100 ml.
The amount of olive oil.
Yeah, but it's also using, you know, two whole onions and
so it's making a sofrito. Sofrito is a stir fry.
Pepper and salt.
Not bad. Because he's probably looked at some nonna's cooking.
Yeah, like more deep frying more than.
The thing I like about Italian, they're genius for making simple things taste like a lot more.
I don't wanna be too judgy. We're not here to judge at all. That's not what we do.
No.
That's not in us. It's not how we are at all. But there's a lot of onions.
But also, have you seen the level of the
olive
oil?
Look at the amount of tomatoes compared to the onions. Did you see that little bowl of tomato on his surface? Look at that.
Oh, that's all he's gonna use?
Italian tomatoes.
Look how much onions. Look at this. No, ma dai. There's no more tomato sauce.
What is that?
Got
two sorts of tomato things going on here. Cans, which are real tomatoes
that's
sitting in juice.
Tomato
paste.
You got a nice tomato
flavor.
That's
not bad at all. Yeah. I love tomato
this is pure
paste.
Pure tomatoes which have been
that,
dried
that
out.
That balances out a little bit. All the onions, but a little bit.
That's
a lot
of
onions.
Onion.
Yeah. Perfect sauce.
Actually, it's incorrect. You don't have to salt it like the Mediterranean Sea.
Stir it up.
That is way too much. That is like some sort of fake idea that goes around. You have to salt it like a seasoned soup. The Mediterranean Sea is very salt.
Don't worry.
You do not want your pasta water like as salty as the Mediterranean Sea.
All right, let's just see if this tastes right.
Is he tasting the water? Why?
Almost.
Incorrect. This is what you do. You toss the pasta in, and as it absorbs, depending upon the shape of the pasta, some like rigatoni need more, absorb more, some less. You have to taste the pasta as it goes in. You cannot know how salty the pasta is gonna be by tasting the water.
Put the pasta
into
a bowl,
very salty.
Put the olive oil on the pasta, toss it up, and that'll stop it sticking. And you get to eat the olive oil, which is
really no! Grave error!
That is the same thing.
Not treasure!
That Ramsay was doing, like, throwing the pasta on the ceiling.
The pasta sticking when you put it in the water, you've got to stand there and stir it until it comes back to the boil.
Okay, this is correct. Do not put olive oil in your pasta water. You don't need to put extra olive oil in the pasta. You have your sauce, that's enough. Orange pasta. This is what I talk about. Don't eat orange pasta. The pasta has to be golden colored. The wheat is like golden cream. If it's orange, it means that it's been flash dried. It is not good, it has lost all of its properties.
I can point out the fact that the actual water in the pot was boiling. So that was the plus of what I've seen.
You know that idea that some people think, you know, it's cooked if you throw it at the fridge and it sticks? Don't do that.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a lot of rubbish.
Correct. Do not throw your pasta to stick it. You know why the pasta actually sticks to surfaces, to the wall, to the ceiling? Some people throw it against the fridge. It's because it's been overcooked and the starches literally make the pasta gluey. That's why it sticks. If it's al dente, it will never stick. So don't even go there. Grave mistake.
And the flavor of the pasta, if you salt the water properly. If you're having lunch with Italians or having a meal with Italians, they always put the pasta into a big bowl in the sauce and it's always stirred up, often at the table, but it's always stirred up before you even you know.
That is true.
Oh, right, exactly.
Don't pour your sauce on the pasta afterwards. The pasta has to be tossed into the sauce.
Cook like you mean.
I can see the onions like graving in there.
Also, no, you know what? Like don't jam. Cook with plastic. Use otherwise, wooden when you spoons. Eat, they're so pasta, rusty.
You're gonna find that watery.
Wash them afterwards.
The plate,
it's salt. If you want to be careful not to have,
it's got a little bit
you know,
of floating on the top. That's fine.
Stuff absorbing. But don't make the perfect tomato sauce with a plastic spoon.
It's
offensive. Also, what's inside this sauce? A ton of onions and tomatoes. What are the tomatoes? Where did he get the tomatoes? That is the essence. Do you know you shouldn't have to be putting sugar in your tomato sauce if the tomatoes are ripe and canned at the ripeness of summer?
So now he's pointing out that this little white spot right there.
Yeah.
That is al dente. That is perfect. Here? It's like by the time I pull it out, it's gonna be cooked.
Wait,
but that's too late.
Concentrate here. There's something happening.
I was serving this.
Did you throw away the pasta?
Yeah, I did throw away all the pasta.
Yeah.
In
the bowl to
serve. Threw away the tears.
No.
Ma
scusa, ma te la.
Look, it's completely sticky.
He said it before. Don't do this. Or no.
Didn't he just say that?
Oh, that's what he meant.
So
like,
this pasta
is
ready to eat.
In the plate.
Serve it up.
No.
In a
what
pasta
is the pasta
bowl.
Water?
Put yourself a microplane or a good grater.
Big
put
mistake.
A little bit of parmesan on it. It's nice.
No, that's not gonna be good.
We could
first
just put
of all,
some basil
you have to take
there,
it out.
Right?
I'm gonna pause it 1 second here.
So just some.
Listen, if you really wanna know how to make this, it's simple. You take the spaghetti, you toss it in the tomato sauce. You add a tiny bit of the tears of the gods. Do you know why? The starches are like glue. They help the pasta cling on the sauce. Then you toss it on a low flame. The pasta is not even fully al dente. You take it out a minute or two before what it says on the box. Toss it into the sauce, hot. A little bit of the tears of the gods, plate it, with a little bit of parmigiano, and also, why add the basil afterwards? The basil goes before and after. The basil have to release the flavor of where they've grown. Yeah. They have to tell the story. They have to be ripped by hands, not cut with a knife because it changes the structure. Ripped by hands, tossed into the sauce, cooked for 1 minute, and then you add a little bit more on top. This is disappointing. Huge mistake.
Yeah.
No pasta water.
I mean, I've seen worse, but
this is. I'm sorry. Yeah. I know he meant well, but you cannot claim this is the
perfect
Italian tomato sauce. No, the pasta gods are crying right now.